And welcome again to Leichhardt Oval here in Sydney, one of the boutique suburban grounds and so beautifully described by Gus Gould. As we look back, a shot of the Latcham Robinson stand, and you see those houses over there in the southeastern corner. When I first called the very first Amco Cup in 1974, they were sitting on the terracotta tile roofs just to get a glimpse of Western Division play Penrith in the grand final and win. And it was just an amazing night, and those people precariously resemble those from 1974. 13 years I spent here at Leichhardt, and let me tell you, many times there were no people here at all, but on finals night it was so, so big. In fact, the only trophy at Cronulla at the moment in the cabinet out there is in fact an Amco Cup victory. So Parramatta are on their way out. They went down to the Dogs last weekend. Both sides are 1-2, Tigers beating the Knights. And Jared leads the Eels out. Tim Manor is the man that will enjoy tonight, no doubt. Tim, of course, is the club captain. Jared, the on-field captain. But there's Tim. He plays his 100th tonight. And he started in Matthews back in 03 and 04. Four origins later, and Tim Manor plays 100. The kid from Guildford. Tom Waterhouse, a quick update.
Rabs, the punters aren't giving a guide in the head-to-head betting, but the tough money's coming, and it says there's going to be plenty of points in this game.
Well, Robbie Farah, Peter Sterling and Cameron just touched on it. It was appropriate for him to sign a four-year extension with the Tigers. He played his junior football with Leichhardt Wanderers and some football with Enfield Federals. And as I said, appropriate that Robbie would aim at becoming just a one-club player. He's the number nine, went through a tough year last year, and he leads the Tigers out with pride. And Aaron Woods, I recall that he played his junior football around here. He got man of the match coming off the bench last weekend, a couple of tries, and he is being touted as an origin player. Unbelievably, he played for the Australian schoolboys, so he was 17 or 18, Aaron, when he first played Toyota Cup under 20s, that is. Player of the year in 2012 for the Tigers, that's the young halfback Jacob Miller. Parramatta will run left to right, and Hain will kick off. It's a blustery night, the humidity is high. Similar humidity, really, to the levels they reached in Townsville last Saturday night. So Braytham Astor in this new strip, which I'll talk about during the night. You'll be able to bid for that on the West Tigers website later in the night, as Woods takes his first carry 32 metres out from the southern end of this ground. And then it's gone through Miller and found Marshall, who kicks big. And it's going down to a back-pedalling Hain, who comes straight down the middle of the ground, and he's put on the ground 35 metres out from his own line. So he plays it back to Tautai. Kensio still unavailable, and Tautai will play it right in the middle of the ground.
Wasn't a great kick there, Ray, from Benji Marshall. They put him in good kicking position. The Parramatta wingers hadn't dropped back, so there was space either side of Jared Hain, but he put it on his chest. Parramatta now third tackle, fourth tackle, already in opposition territory.
Here's Manor. Crowd still streaming into this ground. The traffic conditions and congestion at a maximum as Hain tries to fend his way down the left side of the Parramatta attack. He came up without the ball. Play was allowed to go on. There was suspicion of a knock-on. Roberts puts it up high. Little juggle from Moulton. Moulton comes out, and he will be taken back by the Parramatta forwards to where he came from. And he'll play the ball back on his own 10-metre line. Tim Moulton wearing the number one. And this is Joel Reddy up against his old club today. Played a lot of football with Parramatta prior to that. He came through the ranks in Adelaide. And his dad was down there coaching the Adelaide Rams. Here's Woods again. And a dearth of front rowers at the moment for West Tigers. So Aaron Woods is a welcome sight back. And there's Farah combining with Marshall. Marshall's into the backfield. Floats a long ball. Lawrence was there to receive. And he's pulled down and tackled by Blair and Ryan. So they attack the Tigers. Marshall down the left side. Taken down, loses the ball. The ball comes down to Morgan. Morgan goes away across the ground. Now he straightens it up and he's put down just inside the 20.
Very strong tackle from Chase Blair, and they needed it as well as number four, Jacob Loco, takes it forward. It is not often that Benji Marshall gets hit with a no-look pass, but Robbie Farah, an absolute cracker.
Tautai. Pale blue boots, I guess. Oh, knock on. Advantage applies. The ball taken in for the Tigers by Blair. And now they go blindside to Fulton. And Fulton's up to the 10. So an awful place on the field to make a mistake. And the Tigers attack again through Jack Buchanan. Played down at the Dragons. And now comes away from Blair. And he looks behind and gives it out in front of Woods, who played the ball to Farah. Down on the southern try line, and it's a half volley take by Marshall. Lawrence has scored. Chris Lawrence, the centre, has scored. Sustained attack by the Tigers. They went there once, twice, thrice, and they came back with four.
And Parramatta paid the penalty for poor ball control at their end of the field. I think it was a falcon off the head of Mitch Allgood, which gave the opposition the ball in great attacking position. And then one-on-one, Chris Lawrence up against... There it is there. Yep, gets him in the forehead. Chris Lawrence one-on-one with Chris Sando, who tries to go low on a bigger man. Lawrence is on the outside. Too big, too powerful. First points.
Number four for West Tigers scoring the try after Parramatta built the pressure for themselves with a mistake, a bad pass, and from there it was Lawrence going into score.
They could have actually scored on the previous play when they went short instead of going long. And it's not often you get two bites of the cherry in this game. Parramatta didn't recover well enough. Marshall's called for another ball, whether he thought the original ball was lacking a little bit of air in it. Someone will run off and give it a little bit of a pump, but he didn't like the feel of it, so he's going to have a kick with the other one.
There's a question I've never thought to ask. You don't have to take the conversion with the same ball that the try was scored with?
I have no idea, Stella.
No.
I imagine if the ball breaks, you've got to go and get another ball.
I think you can change it as long as you're able to have some proof that the ball is unfit for goal kicking or whatever. And just a lovely kick down towards the Iron Cove end of the ground. 6-0, Brad Fittler sideline.
Yeah, they're positive signs for the Tigers. We're talking about hole running before the game. Chris Lawrence, there he holds his run there. Benji Marshall copped a bad ball, but his timing was perfect. The other thing we spoke about was speed of the line. When Chris Lawrence gets a ball, he is charging straight through the smaller man, Chrissy Sandow, and over for the first point of the game.
He's a quality player, really, Brad, and I said at his best, he wouldn't be out of place in any team, would he, Lawrence?
Yeah, I think he's carried a few injuries over the last couple of years. When he's playing like this and he's running at holes and looking fresh, he's a fantastic player.
This is Buchanan with the ball now. Played for Farah to sweep away, and here is Corabidi, who, no matter who you follow, I guess, here's the Holden Cup score for you. Tigers 40-6. Yeah, it doesn't matter who you follow, we're hoping to see some of the brilliant speed of Corabidi, who, in his second game only at the top level, scored four tries. And from memory, that was against Parramatta. Here is Moulton now. Gets the ball away to Blake Ashford, and Ashford is almost to the halfway line. High scores between these two clubs are not foreign. In fact, here's Blair, who just celebrated a birthday during the week just gone. And Adam plays the ball before it finds young Miller, and he stabs it down into the corner. It's getting over towards the sideline, and Hayne has made the play of the ball. It had nice weight on it off the boot of Miller. Sando had to scurry into dummy half. Chase Blair has now got a combination of four Tigers on him. He loses the ball. Knock on against Parramatta, so the men in black and gold, particularly black, they go on the attack again.
Yeah, great energy here from the Tigers to start the game. And that's what it's like when it comes to Leichhardt Oval with a big crowd here. It's very hard for the visiting players to come here and play well. You've really got to be mentally on your game and strong to stay in it and keep grinding and competing. Otherwise, the crowd and the opposition can overwhelm you with their early enthusiasm. And that looks like what's happened here
Parramatta are just being blown off the park at the moment. Can't get themselves into the contest.
That adds weight to the value of that kick from Jacob Miller, forcing Jared Hayne to play at the ball. He wanted it to go over the sideline. But Blair was left on his own. Next ruck.
Heads down now.
And four hit him and forced the error.
So the Tigers coming up with the ball, and Corabidi left his left side flank and angled it back towards where the scrum was set just a fraction earlier. Blair playing it to Farrah. They go deep and wide, right side. Miller applying Marshall, hand off to Ashford. And Blake playing the ball just inside the 10-metre line. Here's Woods again. As I mentioned, two tries off the bench to take man of the match last weekend. Farrah again, a decoy, Marshall and Ben Holstein, and now Reddy, and Reddy bundled in the touch. Couple of metres out from the line, and Jacob Loco prominent with Tautai in that defence.
Yeah, really nice there from Parramatta. That's a nice recovery, and will do them the world of good confidence-wise. They'll feel as though now they're just starting to get their sights in here with their defence. Well covered. They had players coming from the inside, plenty of assistance, and just bustled him towards the sideline.
We'll never forget the corresponding game last year at Parramatta Stadium when the Tigers went out to 31-0 after 66 minutes. And Parramatta, incredibly, after the Tigers folded up the tent, scored 30 points in 14 minutes to go down by one. That was the corresponding game up at Parramatta last year. And this is Loco, 12 out, running away from, as I said, the Iron Cove end of the ground. This is Tim Manor. Of course, his family losing John just a short time back. And now this is all good in number 8 for Parramatta in a new strip. When I say a new strip to me. Sando kicks big and deep, and it's going to...
Wow.
Oh, it's a whacking kick. That's a 40-20.
Wow.
Gee, he can kick a big ball. Sando, how long was that?
Well, there was nearly 20-10 or 30-10, wasn't it? How far did this go? He catches this inside his own 30, slams it, absolutely nails it, fires it out of a cannon, and finds touch 10 metres out. That's a 30-10.
Yeah, I think you'll find it's his second of the season, and he attempted two against the Warriors, and it was freakish how they didn't come up as 40-20s. One actually reversed back outside the 20 and went out 20 and a half from the line. So he's worked hard on that, and it's a big, big play in any game.
That's the one they needed, Peter. Right there and then they needed a big play because they were starting to dig into a hole. Here's Hayne up on the blind side of the scrum, and Lawrence is there to meet him and put him away. So away from Keating, it's found Ryan. This is Matthew Ryan, son of a former Tiger, Trevor, and a Balmain junior as they come with a play up the middle, and all good is close. Did he get it down? Did he lose it? He lost it. Ball lost in ground, in goal by the attacking side. 100 metre restart. Well, the Tigers go to the attack immediately.
He did all the hard work, didn't he? Good run back on the inside, good angle, hit, spin, turn, second effort, third effort, over the top, slam it down. And underneath there, I think it was Molson, Tim Molson, that came up with the save.
The Tigers straight back on the attack, and Ashford over on the eastern side as that hill over there now in front of the old scoreboard is loaded up with people. So Farrah sweeps it to young Miller, and he's off his left and he's off his right. Tackled by Ryan, but he had them stretched. All good involved. Now to Farrah. Farrah puts it up. The chase is on. The leap is on. It's gone forward off Reddy. And Hayne has got the ball. And it will come back
tackle,
for the knock-on to be played.
Here.
And it will be changeover 10 metres out from the Parramatta line.
Not a lot of urgency from the Parramatta players under that. They allowed Joel Reddy to fly high. And came off his chest. Loco again, the man to bring it forward, although he's now going backwards. End-to-end stuff.
Parramatta with Sando. going wide early. And that is Morgan who plays the ball on the 20. Here's Ryan. Tim Manor then taking one himself. And he's got enormous leg drive, Tim Manor. It doesn't matter whether it's a standing start or at full speed that he gets the ball. He's got tremendous drive through the thighs. Moulton coming away from the 10 and using Reddy. Himself a very competent fullback. And the penalty goes to the Tigers.
You kept it there the whole way, mate. No. You kept it there the whole way, all the way to the ground, mate.
Yeah, Rabbits, today's big forwards have got to have speed off the mark. They don't get back deep and run onto the ball like they did in the old days. They tend to stand up on the advantage line, grab the ball, and then try to accelerate from the standing position. And they all do it, so it must be the most effective way. So it's very, very important that your big men have got good leg speed and can get off the mark quickly, because they just don't wind up like they used to.
Tigers with Braithen Astor coming down this western side of the ground. And there's Corrovitti with a little exhibition of how quick he is off the mark. He scored 8 tries in an 8-game career. Corrovitti through Miller on to Marshall. Came off a Parramatta player who I think played at the ball. And it's come off Parramatta, so it'll be a scrum with a loose head and feed to West Tigers.
Scrum, Tigers ball.
I do think there'll be a fair bit of kicking from the Tigers tonight. They'll have noticed that there is inexperience on the flanks for the opposition team, and both Marshall and Farrah up trying to take advantage of that.
Arrow comes to 9 after Easter.
Righto, Jacob, head in. Jared, head in for me.
Some wonderful show coming to our network after Easter.
Stay in for me.
Out. Here's Ashford now. Taken down. Well, he wasn't taken down. He was able to offload, and Reddy was at the alert. And Reddy is spun down by Loco, but they go back and they hit the same side of the ground through Liam Fulton. And Fulton plays it back to Reddy. Reddy comes away to Farrah. Farrah out at first, and he lays it back on Adam Blair. I guess a disappointing year last year. And then Farrah comes on to Miller. Miller showed it to Woods, gave the ball away to Buchanan. And Buchanan is taken high, enticing Allgood to go down around the knees. And then Farrah goes away to Blair. In a hole. And he's pulled down and tackled by Rennie Matua. And here's a ball, grab it into the in goal, and Keating takes it dead. So the next best thing to a try is to get it back again for another set.
He's very adept at this play, Robbie Farrah. He finds the in goal more than any dummy half I've ever seen. It's not easy to get it through a gap this close to the line. There's legs and bodies everywhere, but he consistently gets it into the in goal, either producing tries or line dropouts just like this. It's a real talent he's got.
Yeah, that's a bit straight. It's Tim Moulton's. He's on the fly. Would have led the chase. It's the dropout, low trajectory. First bounce to Moulton, who finds Buchanan.
Runs at the left shoulder of Ben Smith, who together with Mitchell Allgood put him down on the 30-metre line. Here's Corrovitti. And he's gone over the top of one. He's down to the 10. Sando did well. Ben Smith made the final tackle. Farrah then to the middle of the ground, to Miller to show and then go. He's very nippy, very evasive penalty.
Yeah, dangerous tackle, I think, to find Ray's. Legs were lifted and there was a drive in
lifting
the tackle.
Lifting tackle, dangerous tackle. It doesn't matter. Doesn't matter if it's this high off the ground or that high. Doesn't matter.
And Shane Hayne explaining it. And that's the reason why. Matua appearing to lift and drive.
Boy, I'm surprised at this.
Yeah, you felt a try was coming, didn't you?
3 sets in a row. This would have been 4.
I just want to show you this run again from Marika Corrovitti, and I keep saying to you that speed is one of the greatest assets in your team. Speed is also power. If the man who is quick is also hard and brave, he can become quite a weapon. Look at this. Speed produces power. 1, 2, 3, bang, out the other side he comes. People that are quick are also very powerful if they choose to be so, and Marika Corrovitti is extremely courageous with the way he runs the ball.
Bit of Aquila Uwate in that, Ray.
You're not wrong. There's a lot of similarity, isn't there? Of course, national heroes these days. And here's Marshall from right in front, so he gets the penalty. A surprising penalty, but it takes them out to this lead here of 6-0 as we take a break. And as you come back, the ball floating down into the in goal to be received by the West Tigers. 8-0 the score. Just correcting myself as I through to the break. 8-0 in favour of the Tigers. Lawrence a try, converted, and then Marshall a penalty. So 25 metres out from their own line. Swept by Blair. Gone through Fulton. Gone under Ashford. Ashford tried to come in and away and go through, and he's got Fulton a dummy half, and he's out towards the halfway line. And seemingly they came out there with ease. Played in the middle of the ground by Fulton. Farrer's going to kick out of dummy half, and Hayne would go back and hope this goes dead, but it's sitting down. And where's the chase? It's led by Farrer. And Farrer's there to meet Hayne and put him down 5 metres out.
Brilliant.
Good work. Good work by the captain from the Balmain West Tigers.
Rift of the Parramatta players coming back. They're on their heels. They've had no football. And they've lost
He's lost the ball, Jared Hayne, on the 20-metre line. And Jacob Miller gives it to Liam Fulton. Fulton's 11 out. In front of the southern uprights, Buchanan then chopping back off his left foot. He's 5 metres away. 8-0 in favour of the Tigers. Now to Miller, who picks the pass out to Anesta. 7 metres out from the line. Parramatta scrambling to keep them at bay. And Farrer to Lawrence looking for two. He's got two. Chris Lawrence has scored again. So 8 becomes 12.
And it's the same recipe. Chris Lawrence getting in a position to take on Chris Sando one-on-one. There were bodies either side, but it was Chris Sando's tackle as the ball popped out. Aaron Woods actually did a good job to force that. Jared Hayne blowing up, but one-on-one, spinning, and Chris Lawrence gets his second.
So Chris Lawrence gets his second try of the night. And the Tigers go out to 12-0 with Marshall to attempt conversion. It's still 29 degrees here in Sydney, and the humidity, as I told you earlier, very, very high. Talking of high, I mentioned the scores between these two clubs. It's not foreign for them to be high. Marshall takes the conversion. It's beautiful. Absolutely gorgeous. Straight between the uprights, over the dot, Andrew Johns.
Yeah, carbon copy of the first rider to Chris Lawrence. Just too big and strong. Chris Sando one-on-one with the centre. He's always going to be in that close to the line. I wonder if Ricky Stewart might think about moving Ben Roberts and swapping Chris Sando over, because only 22 minutes in, they're really targeting that side of the Parramatta defensive line.
In round 22 last year, the Tigers won 51-26. And I seem to remember that Parramatta back in 2001 beat the Tigers 66-12 here. That's what to cap something I was alluding to earlier.
The one thing that Chris Sando needs to do is to make sure that in that situation, Chris Lawrence doesn't get to his outside, as he's done on both occasions. Completion rates 3 from 7 for the Eels, 10 from 12 for the Tigers. They had all the football.
Marshall now. Pulled down back on his own 30-metre line.
But Parramatta contributing to their own demise with simple errors.
Here's Farrer. And the 15 for Parramatta. Darcy Lussick is out there now. Blair appears keen for work. Moi Moi also out there now. And so they go back to the right side. And Marshall puts it end on end. And it rockets towards that sideline on the eastern side.
Had a good look at the West Tigers last Sunday when they played against the Panthers, and looking at their style of play, I made the comment that their attacking style hasn't changed much at all under Mick Potter. He sort of left things the way they were as they were under Tim Sheens. And why not? Because they always had a great attacking game. But they're playing infinitely better tonight than they did on Sunday. Even though they won on Sunday, this is a much more polished, organised, clinical performance
than what we saw from them only 5 days ago. Pretty impressive, actually.
You're watching VB Friday Night Football from Leichhardt in Sydney. Ciao, ciao. 15 out from his line.
Well, the Eels must get to their kick this set. They haven't done so a lot tonight, keeping outside his own 20. They've got to get some ball and they've got to get to the other end of the field. That's Moy Moy's first touch.
Just outside the 30-metre line. Fui Fui Moy Moy. Now a run for Darcy Lussett. In addition to Parramatta from Manly. Now Sando from outside the 40 and he's kicking long and it's going down and away over the dead ball line in front of the Keith Barnes stand down there at the northern end.
He's improved his kicking technique, Chris Sando. He's firing that off the boot. I've never seen the ball come off the boot that strong from him before. He's always been a reasonable kicker, but tonight he's absolutely launched a couple.
Ready it is, playing the ball. Lawrence. Ryan and Keating getting the defensive work done. And the penalty goes to West Tigers. They weren't back 10, according to Hayne.
Yeah, brilliant play by Robbie Farah, noticing that the markers were lazy getting up. And this has happened a couple of times. You remember the first break of the game came Farah out of dummy half. Just realising they're not set, they're a little bit disorganised. Charges back in and gets the penalty. And there were Tigers players pushing up around him into holes. If Parramatta are that lethargic getting off the tackle player all night, Robbie Farah will carve them up.
30 metres out then to take the free kick. And Astor chiming in with Lawrence. Corabini will find himself at acting half. And it's an awful pass. It's gone to Miller, and Miller turns it back on the inside to Siu Manu Whānau, who's on for Balmain.
Who was it
West
again?
Tigers.
Who was it?
Siu Manu Whānau.
Thank you.
I knew there'd be somebody tried to make a fool out of me by my first attempt. But anyway, here's Farah, and it goes back, and it's gone for Manasta, gone to Bell, gone to Miller. Miller across the back, wide to Marshall, short to Fulton, and Fulton will play the ball. Now, he runs a gunner. He runs a detour, I should say. Siu Manu Whānau. And now here's Marshall. Going back for depth to Farah. He puts a left foot grubber in, but the bounce is good for Sando. And he's looking for the dirt and finding it.
He wasn't able to get that one in the in-goal area, but a real sense of control about the performance tonight so far from the Tigers. Seen that in the kicking game. Miller kicking it close to the sideline. Marshall on the far side into the in-goal area. They've already got one restart from under the post. Michael Potter now will want that control to remain, because in the past, when there are plenty of points that the Tigers have accumulated, that's when they can lose their way and get loose.
Sando with that big boot of his again. Well taken by Moulton. So he's gone to Corabidi. He'll open up. And speed took him through the first one.
Is there a little shoulder charge attempt there from Chris Sando?
I think he pulled out at the last minute. It was normally the ones where he stands his ground and drops his shoulder into them, but he just pulled out.
Well, this is Siu Manu Whānau, and that's the, well, half-hearted shoulder charge from Sando. And here's Farah back to Fulton. Fulton away, down from Blair, back to Marshall. Marshall skipping and crabbing across the 40-metre line, turns it on the inside for Lawrence. Not a bad bloke to go to. Two tries for him tonight. Played by Chris Lawrence. Marshall's got a stacked-up blindside. Goes to Moulton. There's a kick. Played at. Six more tackles for the Tigers.
Well, look out here. It's all running for them, isn't it?
Marshall. And Siu Manu Whānau.
You better get used to calling it by the look of it, Ravitch. He can play this boy.
Farah. And then Blair off his right. And then he reverses into them. And hanging on is Lussick around the leg.
Trouble on the far side, Parramatta.
That's where they're going. Farah, Miller, Miller, Marshall. Marshall held it back for two decoys. And then Reddy had to clean up what was left of it, and he plays it just inside 20. Marshall now, back to Bell, Matthew that is. Siumanu Fanai, he is with the ball, 10 metres out, middle of the ground. Ryan and Lusick making the tackle. Lofted ball from dummy half. Bad pass to Marshall, who kicks off. Parramatta player has gone right up over the top of the bar. And Korobidi is with the ball for the Tigers. Taken by Moy Moy. It was Chase Blair with the acrobatics. Now it's come to Blair, the other Blair, Adam. He'll play it 3 metres out from the line. Back to Farrah. Farrah dummies once, goes to Matthew Bell. Will he reel over and get it away? It's on the ground, scooped away, batted away. On the ground, still there, on the boot. Reddy comes after it. It's still play on and Reddy's got the ball. Penalty goes now to West Tigers.
Yeah, Jacob Loco here.
Pull him back.
Pulling Joel Reddy away from the ball. Quite sure how the Tigers didn't score there, but they are about to.
You want me to explain? Yeah. If he's going to the ball, he doesn't hold the jumper, mate.
Things like that.
Yeah, doesn't matter, he's holding the jumper. That's holding the player back, and that's what the penalty's for. Okay? You mightn't agree with it, but that's it.
Whether Jared Hayne thought he'd get any drag out or not, it was what Parramatta needed, just to get a bit of a break. And that's the penalty against Loco, stopping Reddy to get into the football. Here they come again.
10 out from the line. Coming to the middle of the ground, Miller. Looks like he might be the answer they're looking for. Farrah giving it to Blair. He beat Moy Moy. He's held by Lussett. Lussett's got the leg, and Blair finding the ground. Played to Farrah. Farrah long, and Miller off his left foot, and then dragged down by the number six. And here goes Aceford, the other centre. He's gone over now. They hunt as a double, they combine beautifully, and Blake Aceford on the right centre gets his share of the spoils.
That was coming, an avalanche of possession. Again, that must have been three or four in a row. Marker not back, Aceford read that and took off, put his head down, slammed his way through two defenders.
Blake Aceford, the other centre, gets the third try of the night, so the centres have cleaned up the lot. They've got the pool.
Well, it's just weight of possession, isn't it? It's relentless from the Tigers. As I said, extremely clinical. It helps when you've got all the ball, but a lot of that's Parramatta's problems too. They're giving away penalties, and it's just building up on them now. They cannot get into this game. Only one side's playing football. The other side's getting tackling practice.
What this team has to do is not get out of the game like they did in that match I was talking about earlier. Marshall missing with the conversion. Try scorer, I was talking to our networks, played his football with Paddington Colts, so he's an Eastern Suburbs junior.
It's good vision here from Blake Aceford. He realises that Rennie Matura is at first marker, but there's no second. He scooted off, dived down, got down low. Take advantage of all that possession that they have enjoyed at that end of the field.
Yeah, very few juniors get out of the coop at the Roosters, but as luck would have it, Blake Aceford, I think, was the nephew of Ryan McDonald, the recruitment manager for Balmain. So, whilst the Roosters had him on a scholarship, blood got in the way of water there, Robert.
Yeah, I was just going to make the comment too. The adage is that blood is thicker than water.
Well, that was unbelievable, the statistics just up there. Parramatta 5 from 9. They've had the football 9 times. Just 19 for the Tigers, and Benji Marshall has drilled it into the third row.
It looked like his left leg gave way here. He lost all balance as he kicked this, and he sort of knew it as soon as he hit it, that it was spraying up onto the hill. And it looked really awkward as he sort of falling backwards, and he went, oh, no. Sort of that look rabbits gets when he has that tee shot that sprays out to the right.
No, I don't think you can go there, not this week.
Nah, 40 points this week. He's,
you can't go there this week.
He's very Stay good. Stay here, Chris. That sounds a bit strange here, Rats. But if Parramatta can get over here, even going in at 18-6 at the break, they'd live with that after what they've endured this first half. As I say, much of it's self-inflicted, as Hayne tries to fling Lawrence off, can't do so.
This is Morgan in 3. And he'll play the ball 32 metres out. 15 missed tackles to one on the Holden statistic. And here it is coming back and away to Darcy Lussett.
It will make very interesting reading at half-time when we go through those statistics.
Keating, Roberts. And behind Matua, coming from behind him, was Loco. He steps out of a tackle, Loco. Gets the ball away in a shovel pass. Back to Hay. Here's Sander. Looks inside, goes outside. Morgan for the line, and Morgan is short. Sliding defence from the Tigers. On the bounce to Sander. Now it's with the 14. And he takes it across the ground. Paulo, he fended away from one. He's 9 metres out from the line. Five gone for Parramatta. It's come from Keating. Gone to Roberts. Puts a little dab on it. It's gone over the dead ball line. But there's an appeal from Tautai that is bound to fail and it does.
Now you look at the other end of the field, the number of times that Tigers have pinned Parramatta. Parramatta had to find the in goal there and force a line drop out for the Tigers. Just couldn't do it. Just lacking that little bit of finesse or maybe a little bit of good fortune. Sunday footy out to Centrebet Stadium. The Oak Panthers take on the Rabbitohs.
Centrebet Stadium and the Oak Panthers, eh? Up against the Rabbits. And Sam is back for this match. You people out at the foot of the mountains. Get there to watch your own team, but you're going to see some of the game's best players out there on Sunday with Greg and Sam. They're building a lovely side under Michael Maguire. As Farrow puts a kick down over Jared's head and it's standing on its point, and Hayne runs away over towards Tautai's wing. But he's tackled out on the 20-metre line. 10 of their last 13 games, West Tigers have won here at Leichhardt, so they've got an affinity to the place. And five of the last six encounters between them and the Eels have been won by the West Tigers. Corabidi's got a lot of space between him and the defence. Look at him go. Look at him go, and Sando.
A shoulder charge.
Yeah, I was just going to say, was that a shoulder charge? Hello, Ryan decides that something happened there that he didn't like. With Corabidi.
No, Jacob, Jacob.
Miller
Jacob.
Pulls Roberts out of the ruck.
Jacob, come on.
I'm not quite sure what inflamed Matthew Ryan.
Well, there was plenty of solid contact there, wasn't there? Sando stood his ground.
No.
It was semi in the shoulder charge range, but what else is he going to do with a bloke hurtling at him like that? 100 mile an hour, you've got to protect yourself.
Matt Ryan, which they didn't choose him, trying to punch the first punch after that. Kurabidi pushes him, and then Matt Ryan punches him.
Matt Ryan trying to punch.
Yeah.
Where's Matt?
You got
that, bro?
Kurabidi giving him a smack over the cheek. So here's the first to throw.
We've ruled the way. Yeah, I never liked that. The retaliator being the culprit.
He gets out and throws a punch at the player.
That's the call. No. Penley's going against you, okay? The punch, okay. Penley, see, Jared?
Can you see the video?
No.
Matt Ryan doesn't do anything.
We've got it on field. We have it on field.
Doesn't have a shot at him. Now, this third man in and all of that, if the original incident didn't happen, you wouldn't get other people coming in. And I've got no doubt there that Corabetti initiated that fracas or rally or
brouhaha.
That's the one.
I'm a little bit mystified there. I'm sorry. I thought Corabetti actually slapped Ryan across the face.
Yeah, it wasn't a punch. The first punch was Ryan.
I said
the first. Apparently,
but I can slap you across the face. You don't mind? No. I thought it would go the other way, to tell you the truth. So it's Lawrence, and the ball goes loose and it goes over to Bell.
Well, they must maintain this scoreline, Parramatta. Can't get any more than 18 going into halftime.
There's Lawrence, and the ball goes to ground. That's off the legs of Farrer and right back to Corabidi. And Corabidi is very much aware of that sideline and the danger of it. He plays the ball 10 away. Long pass over to Farah. Farah goes high over to his jumpers, and Fulton's under it. So is Tautai. And Tautai comes down with the ball for Parramatta out in the field of play. Roberts. It's Matua. Jumper number 18. He wasn't expected to play. Keating. Roberts. There's a bust. Hayne down the side. Gets the ball away to Tautai. Tautai's inside the 40. He's inside the 30. Supporters coming. He gets it to Jacob Loco. And Loco has the ball dislodged. It still might be a try. Referee Hayne.
Knock on
is called.
Tim Molson and Benji Marshall, I think, have come back to save the day after excellent work from Jared Hayne to put his winger Tautai away. It's in between and in behind. Pass went backwards. Probably needed to put the foot down here instead of backing off. It's actually Robbie Farah back there, not Benji Marshall. Well, what an effort from the skipper and the fullback.
So there's no doubt in the world that it is a knock-on. It was correctly defined. I thought for a moment it might have been described as a rake or a steal. And then the Parramatta player diving on it may have still been given a try, but Shane Hayne had a beautiful view of it and called it straight away. Knock on. West Tigers scrum. 10 out.
No, I'm not going to use it. Well, we've made the decision. We've made our decision. Thanks, Jared. Thank you. Thanks,
it's not a bad call from Jared Hayne.
Take your time, boys. Let's go.
Even if the referee puts the tee bar up to say try, go upstairs to have a look at it.
Robbie, head in. Let's go.
If that was knocked out by a Tigers player, then it could have been a legitimate try. And I'm surprised that the officials didn't go upstairs just to make a bird of it.
This is Lowen to the ball. Woods. Yeah, in deference to that, though, I think Hayne had a very good side of it, and he had a firm opinion. And I think we've said it before on the other side of the scale. I wish they'd make a decision, but he made a decision, and I think he got it right. Molson near the halfway line for young Tim on the Central Coast. This is Aaron Wood. Farah doing quite a bit of kicking out of dummy half, and he puts it over the sideline on the bounce. So 10 metres away from the Parramatta line. And half-time is with us. So the first half, one-way traffic, miles of mistakes. Enormous amount of mistakes. Brad?
Yeah, got Robbie Farah. How are you feeling after the chase? Yeah, it's tough, that one, but you know, to hold him a nil in that first half's a good effort, so we'll do the same in the second.
All right, good luck in the second half, mate.
18 to nil then at half-time in favour of the West Tigers. Coming up in Holden half-time, Andrew Johns, Phil Gould join Cameron Williams to take us through the VB hard-earned first half highlights. Brad Fittler with Nine Orbit. That's next on the home of Rugby League, Nine's wide world of sports. And some of the highlights of the first half, or maybe the lowlights. This was Korobidi and Matthew Ryan. John Skandalis in the blue shirt, the trainer from West Tigers, he decides to throw some water over them just to try and cool them down. Skandalis, of course, played, I think, the second most number of games, or has played the second most number of games for West Tigers in their short career, behind Chris Hyington. Jared Hayne takes them out. So that was another way of Scandy just trying to temper things down a little bit with a spray of water.
Just having a look through those statistics at half-time, Ray, I thought that the West Tigers had a shocking set against Newcastle in round one. Well, they were made look very good by the one put forward by Parramatta in the opening 40 minutes here. 5-0 penalty count. that's always tough to cope with as well. And Parramatta now, having not scored a point in the last 40 minutes against the Bulldogs last weekend, not scoring in the first 40 here, have put together a game without scoring a point, 80 minutes.
These special jumpers being worn by West Tigers tonight, they're the Skyfall jumpers. They're doing a promotion with the James Bond movie. They'll be signed by all the players and up for auction on West Tigers' website, with all proceeds going to charity at the end of tonight. Round announcer's dressed appropriately. He's got a bow tie on. He plays the part of James Bond. And those jumpers will be signed by all of the players, all of the jumpers. And you go to the West Tigers website with all bidding proceeds going to charity.
Good show.
You liked Skyfall, didn't you?
I thought it was excellent.
What's his name, the James Bond of today?
Daniel Craig.
Having a photo taken with him in Madame Tussauds.
Right, boys.
After Princess Diana. There's the kickoff to the second half on Wide World of Sports. And Moi Moi comes back to the 10-metre line for Parramatta. And of course, if you follow Parramatta, you need your team to be the next to score, even though they gave them 31 start last year and scored 30 against them. Matua taken hard with a vice-like tackle from Ashford and Woods. And that is Paulo. Penalty goes to Parramatta against the defenders. Hand on the ball. That's the first penalty for Parramatta. 5-1 the count. Nothing really has gone for them. Peter's gone through it all for you. It's a miserable statistics board for Parramatta, which only makes you sort of half think that 18-0, it'll balance out, and when it does, they might just have something in the tank, something to offer. Sando goes away to Lussick. Good player, this kid, Darcy Lussick. He's a good off-season purchase for Parramatta. A loss for Manly. Roberts, and now Matua tries to shoulder between them. And the ball will be played by Remy. 10 metres out. Here's Parramatta. Hayne is in. He goes no look into no man's land. And Roberts will play. Fourth tackle and a penalty.
Wait there.
Again, hand on the ball.
Wait there.
No, Mark Ben.
Jared Hayne attempted an old Roosters and Sharks play there. It's one of Ricky Stewart's favourites, that late ball to the man wrapping around from behind everybody.
So they've got a good chance here, Parramatta, to get their first points of the night. Keating then away, and it's gone from Paulo through Sando, and it's out with Morgan. The defence sliding across and shutting him down. Hayne to Sando. And here is Lussick. Now they're in the middle of the park. Third tackle is gone. And Hayne stayed alive on the blind side. Ryan Dutt for Morgan. Morgan goes in to score. Well, he dummied and he pirouetted and put the ball down. That's exactly what Parramatta had to be. The team to score first in the second half.
And it was easily done. It did come on the back of two penalties. They had numbers out there. Ryan Morgan went close first half. Well, he got over in the second.
Well, there's your try scorer, Ryan Morgan. 22 years of age and playing his 36th game tonight at the top level. Born out at Liverpool. Played juniors with Greystay. Here's Sando. And he's online, as he normally is. Andrew, sideline.
Here's the side for Parramatta to attack. The inexperienced defensive pairing of Miller and Corabete. Just don't get the numbers right there. And Jared Hayne, a beautiful pass. And Morgan does well. He's showing go and pirouette. But you'll see they just don't get the numbers right. And Hayne, he'll pick them off all night. But this is the side they've got to attack, Parramatta.
Well, you think about the try that Robbie Farah saved
It looked like a certain try just at the end of the first half, and now that one. We could be at 18-12, and the Tigers have had all the possession.
Moi Moi on the kick reception. Paulo holding statistics board. Tigers are 1-7 of 11 when leading at half-time since the start of 2012. Played them by Roberts and it's gone through hands and found Lussick. Lussick has played the ball 35 out. Back for Keating to give to Paulo and then to Sando and then a dummy to Ryan and he goes skirting out wide and then he straightens. Sando's inside 30. He grubbers then for his winger. Blair's in a race for Corabidi. Corabidi, he puts it dead, I believe. It's a line drop out West Tigers. Sando on fire down the right side.
Yeah, and Joey Johns picked it out at half-time. This is the inexperienced side of the field. And Sando will float across field, show and go, show and go, show and go, and then sprints into space, show and go again. Now, he had players streaming down the middle of the field. Had he kicked towards the inside instead of the outside, they may well have beaten Corabetti to the ball. But it's giving Parramatta some confidence here that if they've got possession, they can break the line. How quick was he, Rabbit? Whoosh. He got there quick.
They're both quick. Sando's quick over a short distance. But Corabetti, he is unbelievably fast.
Chase Blair is quick.
Yeah.
And he went straight past him.
Yeah. Moi Moi. Parramatta is showing something here in the early part of the second half with an even share of luck, an even share of possession, that they've got something to offer. Sando for Ryan, the fellow angles back towards the center. Keating Sando. Sando crawling after losing his footing into the embrace of Woods. Now Paulo, and it's gone back to Roberts and gone to ground, and it's now finished up with the Tigers to play on. Moulton tries to turn them around, and Moulton is tackled.
Well, that was a really bad set of six there from Parramatta, and they've compounded it by giving away the penalty because they're under pressure. Then lack of discipline, marching another 10 metres, and here we've got the tap.
Marshall has taken a quick tap and bolted. There's nobody at home. Marshall scores a 70-metre try after he took a quick tap penalty, went through a gap, and away he went.
Entry Sydney Heads. Get every Parramatta player back to the ball. Jared Hayne.
You go, get up, get up, get up.
Exactly. As soon as I call move, you get it again.
We saw Jason Nightingale run a distance down in Wollongong last weekend from a quick tap. Once you're given the mark verbally and physically, you can go. And he's got both there. And every Parramatta player walking back towards his try line.
Well, that's the perfect example of pulling their pants down in public. Parramatta, with a really poor set of six when they had the momentum, turned the ball over, gave a penalty on tackle one for laying on the tackled player because they're under pressure, then verbalised the referee to march him 10 metres, and then strolled back into position for Benji Marshall to take the tap and pull their pants down. Very publicly.
Marshall compounds the felony. Brad Fittler.
Yeah, Rabs, I think sitting up there as a coach, it's pretty hard to take a positive out of this. I've got to say that one positive you could take out of it is you hope that Jared Hayne learned a lesson out of this last 10 seconds of play. You hope that him making a bit of a fool of himself at Leichhardt might save himself later on the season in the semi-final.
There was never any question about the officials being in position. The pocket was back 10, and the other referee was marking the new spot after he had advanced the mark. Now West Tigers get another penalty.
Well, it's all good saying that.
Hey, in fact, Kevin, Darcy Lussick. Time off, Kevin. Time off. It's Darcy Lussick, mate. What's up, mate? Darcy Lussick. Darcy. I copped two blows and then I copped this after that.
What happened? Tell you, mate, won't basically get. What I want you to do now is just listen, please.
I'm going back, you're giving the penalty. I copped two blows from various players around there. Then I get Darcy last hit saying that I'm effing kidding.
Okay.
Okay, he needs to be against the mark.
You need to control him, all right? He doesn't need to start talking to the way the officials, the way he just did then, okay? If you want him to stay on the peak, no matter what he thinks here, righto, he calms it down. Hand on the ball, going up with the ball, okay?
So when like no, another try line, he'll be fair with his hand on the ball.
Way you go, Joe. Way you go, mate. Way you go. Time back on.
It's become an argument from.
Well, you just saw the replay there, the hand was on the ball.
Yeah, and they can't say that they weren't told. Every club, every coach has been told that they would clamp down on this big time. They just let their discipline. It was frustrating for them, of course, to watch Marshall do what he did to them, but they brought it on themselves.
It might be the Parramatta coming out of me, Ray, but I'm not quite sure if Benji actually touched the ball on his foot.
That's an interesting point, you mate.
Well, I'm not sure. It's just in quick motion, obviously. Not that it makes any difference.
Woods.
Well,
I'm glad the quick tap is back. That'll get every side in the competition on red alert. They scored one last week. Same thing, Robbie Fattler to Benji Marshall. He pulled the Panthers' pants down. And tonight they've done it to the Eels. I love the fact that the quick tap is back in the game. Let's have a look.
Oh, gee. He hasn't got it with his boot. He might have got it with his shin.
That's close enough.
And that's a kick. Close enough. I said he might have got it with his shin, but Peter's suspicions are entitled to be high. Here's Marshall dribbling it in and then batted. And, oh, hang on a moment. They got, oh, did he put a hand on it with downward pressure? Tim Moulton.
Wow.
Touch judge is saying something to the man with the whistle.
Clarkey, video review, I've got a try, just check the grounding and the touchline, please.
All right, you've heard it there from Alan Shortle. He's got a try in his mind, but he's worried about the touch and the put down.
Well, the Parramatta player here obviously feels he's got a play at it because he can't allow the chasers to come onto the ball. Marshall gets it in behind him, so he'll run back.
Tautai.
He's decided he's got to play at the ball, so he punches it infield for some reason. It yorks Jared Hayne. He misses it completely, and Humble gets a bubble on it. Moulton, sorry. So that's all right. He's not out. It goes through Jared Hayne's legs. That's a try.
And there's downward pressure.
I've seen things tonight, Ray, that I haven't seen in a long time.
I want to know why he batted it back infield and just not pushed it out over the sideline closest. Why did he feel the need to bat it back? Unless he was trying to get it to Jared Hayne.
He's trying to get to Hayne, no doubt.
Oh, wow. Well, that's a low percentage play, isn't it?
He must believe in miracles, young Tautai.
At York, Jared, he played over the top of it.
Well, took his middle stump.
Yeah. Played right over the top of it.
Peter said he's seen plenty here tonight. Well, I've seen plenty in the last 3 minutes.
The kicking game tonight from the Tigers has been tremendous. Well thought out, well executed. And has kept plenty of pressure on the opposition. As the decision now comes, it'll be green.
You're not colourblind, that's for sure. Timmy Moulton scoring the try. Again, off a Parramatta mistake. And Marshall at the intersection of the 10 and the 20. He hits it and sends it high, straight between the posts. Joey?
Yeah, kids watching at home, have a real good look at this passage of play. And never, ever do this on the field. Don't even do this in backyard footy. Great kick from Benji Marshall. But it's a low percentage play, as Gus said. But even Jared Hayne, Jared dive on the ball. That's one to forget for the Parramatta Eels.
You can normally trace things back in a game. And if you go back to third tackle, Parramatta on the attack, they've scored a try. Paulo throws the ball behind Roberts. The opposition get it. All the pressure's taken off. Then came the penalty, then came the penalty, then came the try. You can trace it back to where Parramatta just handed the ball over too easily when they were back in it.
Can you believe in the space of 4 minutes, just as the Parramatta fans, wherever they might be watching, their hopes went up, and 4 minutes later, West Tigers have put another 12 on them.
Well, they had reason for optimism, didn't they? As we stated, had Loco put that ball down before half-time and then, sorry, after half-time, conceivably, they're right in the game, only six off the pace. Look.
Chase Blair.
Again, the kick, third tackle. Robbie Farah down into the corner. Parramatta, well, they've got players back on the 30-metre line, still coming back.
Morgan.
But the next set of six, they didn't capitalise on the momentum they had. It was an awful set of six. Four really boring plays and then a drop ball and the rest has just been Wooshka.
Moi Moi. Trying to bend them back. Now Roberts. Pulls him up, ends him and puts him down. And now they spin it wide out to Sando for that boot of his from just outside the 40, but it's going down the middle and here is Reddy. Come to Ryan and Ryan is able to put him down.
Coach Michael Potter now will want his team to continue in the same vein they have so far tonight, not to become the Harlem Globetrotters just because the scoreline is so lopsided. Keep the control that they've been able to muster out there for the 53 minutes.
Lawrence on his own 40 metre line, Jacob Miller back to Aaron Woods. Woods will play the ball in the centre of the ground on VB. Friday night football on Nine. Free to air. No charges. It's all complimentary. Here's Hayne. Keating has got the markers. He had them covered. Here's Sando. For a moment he might have been able to pop a ball away to Hayne.
Great tackle in Asta.
Here is Reddy Matua. 12 metres into West Tigers territory. And Jacob Loco. Ladies football. I think at one stage at the same junior club as Jared Hayne. Now Paulo. Sando. Back and knocked on by Hayne. Maybe not. Knocked backwards, said Shortle. Ball with Morgan. Farrah's with Morgan. Blair to Sando, midfield bomb, high, and Moulton, he almost lost touch with it, but he took the catch, well done.
What a catch. Now, we were watching that ball come down. That was one of those spiral bombs. What a mistake here to the Tigers. That was one of those spiral bombs that Andrew Johns pointed out last night in our coverage. That ball swirled. Watch it swirl late away from Moulton. Comes down and swirls away from him. And he just gets his hands out in front. That's a brilliant take. That ball is going away from him very quickly at the last 15 feet of its fall. And he did really well to catch that. And his teammates let him down by dropping it on next play.
It was interesting last night, Joe, giving us that kicking lesson in your company under your questions. And then Cooper Cronk basically then gave us the lesson in full reality. It's lovely to watch. Here's Hayne. And this is Tanganoa, who debuted last weekend in the same game as Tautai. Tanganoa playing it slowly. Paulo to Manor. Manor shoveled one away. Back to Paulo, then to Roberts on the ground for Loco. He did well, Jacob. Got rid of one, tries to shake off another. And they eventually put three into the tackle to put him to ground. Tautai. Now Roberts pops it up. Paulo down. 9 metres out from the line. Fourth tackle for Parramatta. Keating to the right side, Roberts. Dummy one. And then behind another to Sando. And Ryan ran decoy. Hayne puts a pass out. Bounces down and away. Blair comes back to Sando. Sando runs into the shoulder of Buchanan. And Sando playing the ball 20 out. Lots of passing, not much progress. As Roberts is taken by Blair. The kick goes down to Reddy with the knee out in front, which I would have thought was acceptable for most markers.
I get really disappointed, Ray, in the modern game with the premeditation in the attack. At the beginning of that set, Joseph Paulo went to a flat man. If he'd have gone behind, they actually had an overlap. Now, Cooper Cronk's a great example. He might have a play in mind, but he then plays what's in front of him and throws the right pass. But too many players today, they get in these structures and they know they're going to throw it to somebody before the play's actually unfolded in front of them.
Buchanan. And the ball is lost.
Oh, just dropped the ball, buddy.
Parramatta gets another chance. They've had one big bite of the cherry, and I thought for a moment, hello, here we go. A repeat of last year, but now they get another little bite.
He actually put that down on the foot of one of the Parramatta players.
Tigers in. Let's go. Join in, boys.
At Parramatta's first night in the competition, they got absolutely flogged by the Newcastle Knights, and I got a stream of emails from disgruntled West Tigers supporters saying, oh, we're going to win the wooden spoon, or we're terrible, we're in for a long year. 2 weeks later, they've won 2 out of 3, and not looking too shabby at all.
Blair, that's a strong run by him. And here's Manor, and Manor's lost the ball, Moulton has it. And Blair has taken care of Moulton. Marshall taken by Blair.
Heads away now. Lock in, Marcus, lock in.
20 metres out from their own line. Strong tackle by Ryan on Buchanan. Here's Jacob Miller. He goes long and lofted behind Anasta. Cleaned up over there by Korobidi. And Korobidi pulled down inside his own 20-metre line. So here's Adam Blair again now. And met by Tanganoa. He's pulled down with the help of Manor on the 30-metre line. That looks like, I think it's Murdoch Masilla, it is. On the 40-metre line. And Farrah kicks down to the wing where Sando had fallen back to help Hayne. Who's now got the ball. Loco. Haynes had a running battle with the referees tonight. He's been in more debates than Julia Gillard.
Yeah, that's something Parramatta's got to look at. I mean, it's one thing to make a bloke like Jared Haynes captain. It's another thing to know if he's ready for it and everything the captaincy offers. And I do think he's been distracted by the captaincy tonight, both in his play and his demeanour with the referees.
Roberts in the way, asking, and got the ball away to Big Ben Smith, but he didn't have the acceleration to capitalise. Roberts.
Yeah. I'm not saying take the captaincy off Jared Haynes. I'm just asking the question as to what training or assistance he's been given with this new responsibility. Because I think he's going to need some more assistance if he's going to maintain that role and do it well.
Tackle one!
7-8.
Hold, Jacob.
Buchanan. Now Blair.
Tackle two! He's 10.
Korobidi's coming off and Eddie Pettibourne is going on. Live on 9, Wide World of Sports on Sunday morning. James Brayshaw and Grant Hackett at 10 o'clock. 11 o'clock, the Sunday footy show. Scott Prince, special guest of Peter Sterling. 30-6, the Tigers leading here at Leichhardt as Braith Anasta runs an angle back towards the 30-metre line, middle ground. Marshall, short ball, short chip, I mean. Ball stopping nicely. Tau Tai is with it.
In Corbetti's absence, Blake Ashford, the right centre, has gone across to play on the left wing. And so Liam Fulton will play inside Joel Reddy on this right side.
Manor. 100 games tonight for Tim. It's not the game you really want to play your 100th in. Well, certainly not at the moment, but it's going to take a miracle to get him a victory tonight. Roberts kicks big inside 40. Bouncing down into in goal. Molson. Reddy's back there. Here's Reddy. And then eventually here's the chases. Eagles versus Tigers, Thursday night at Gosford Blue Tongue. And Friday we go to Brisbane for the Broncos up against Melbourne. That will be a bumper crowd. Good Friday night at Suncorp, Brisbane up against Melbourne. Well, Canterbury, I think, went a long way to showing other clubs that, yeah, they're good, but they're beatable. They did it without four of their stars. They went within an ace of it. Anthony Griffin will be pumping his team up with that belief during the week, I would imagine. Murdoch Masila plays the ball, and Masila, Farah. Not a strong kick. It's deliberately aimed down towards the touchline, and Jared had it covered. Lawrence makes the tackle with the help of Buchanan and Anasta. Here's a long pass from Sando, lofted over to Roberts, and Roberts tries to zed his way up and through the defending line. He's tackled on the 40-meter line. Matt Keating able to pinch 10 meters. The markers are dropping off their job. We've had 66 minutes of the game go, and Parramatta throwing it along the line, and Morgan is with the ball. Sando back to Paulo, and Paulo spun onto his back on the last tackle for Parramatta. Keating, Sando, and there she goes, the bomb, and Molson will go up. No, he's put it down, Molson, and it's a knock-on against the
Tiger. He's jumped up to the ball. That's nothing wrong with that. He's done nothing.
He's claiming that Hayne interfered with him.
Well, he flashed at it.
He touched it, but it went back.
Hayne was having a dip. He's having a dip, and Molson's knocked on clearly.
Are there boys?
That's the angle I would think of Corabidi. Crowd is very good as Parramatta spin along the line. Loco. This is about where that big resurgence came last year, when they scored 30 points in the last 14 minutes. Manor, middle of the ground for Keating. Now it's gone to Paulo. Second man away for Roberts. He'll score. Roberts, I thought he was going to dive on the ball in goal. But it's been saved by Molson.
Well, that was a premature grubber kick. I don't think it was really on there. And maybe an admission from the Parramatta side. They've run out of ideas here. Wasn't really much doing there at all. Molson covered it up nicely.
Marshall. Betty ball.
They've just got into a little bit of a slumber themselves, West Tigers. They're looking at the clock and the scoreboard and feeling very good about themselves.
Barrow inside for Fulton. 40-meter line. Farrah again, Marshall again, kicking deep, and bouncing over the crossbar, and Jared Hayne has to play at it. Marshall leads the procession, and Hayne gets back 2 metres into the field of play. It's surprising that ball stopped like it did. Tauta struggling. Grinding run out to the 20-meter line. Paulo. And there's one out the back. You might as well play Razzle Dazzle now. Keating, Sando, Tanganoa. And he's up to halfway. Put down by Fulton. Well, Fulton's offside. Surely Fulton's offside.
Liam's offside on the ground.
Well, I wonder what he was thinking, Liam Fulton.
He dropped off a tackle. The man was tackled. He played it back, and he's laying on the ground there offside and grabbed at the ball. It was a bit silly.
Take a pain away injury update, Brad Fittler.
It seems as though Marika Korobidi won't be playing again this evening. He's got a twisted left ankle.
Centre of the ground, Parramatta. Here is Tanganoa.
Sounding a bit more dire than it actually was. He said, won't be playing again for...
Line speed.
Sando, Manor. Elbow up in the chest of Murdoch Masila. And Tim Manor playing the ball. So can Parramatta get it over the line here? It's come from Roberts and gone quickly along the back line. There's a chance in the corner for Tautai. He went in and away. He got the ball over the line. I think it's a try. I think it's a try. The touch judge is happy with it.
Clarkey, tackle four. We have a try. We're checking touchline, please. I'm happy with the grounding.
Yeah, touch judge wasn't entirely happy to give a definite. Young man in just his second first grade game. Got the green boots on. They're up in the air, as we've seen a couple of times lately. And that'll be a try. It happened in Melbourne last night too, I think, didn't it? Player went over and the feet were on the defender, but over the line.
You're right. I think they're teal.
Sorry, that's green for me. That's as close as I can get, bro. So.
I understand that, but I struggle to find teal.
Well, you've got a teal pull
over straight for green.
That, so.
There's green. There. A break and we're back. Well, there was a big smile as he made his walk back down amongst his teammates. From young Tautai, second game, he scores his first try in the top grade. The kick is beautiful from Sando. Andrew, sideline.
Yeah, I'd like to see more of this in the modern game where they just catch and draw and pass. Too many times, as Sterlo said, they premeditate where they're going to hit. This is draw and pass there. It's good inside play. And then Tautai, well done, coming back from that debacle on the in goal. The modern winger, how they can contort their bodies. Get their legs up in the air when they're going over the sideline. It's a real art.
There he is. I'm not sure of his Christian name pronunciation. V-A-I. Is it Vay or Vi? Vi. All right. Thank you, David.
That's one. Eddie. His team. Lock in. Hold. Go.
So here is Tanganoa now.
Tackle down. Not a colour you see a lot of. Teal.
Eddie.
I'll tell you when I saw plenty of it. Those Penrith jumpers they brought out at one stage. Whatever happened to the black magic up there, I don't know. They went teal. Here's Hayne. But it was pre-Gould, of course. 30-12 now. In the last 10 minutes. In half a minute, and here is all good. Breaking into the back play. Keating's looking for support. Here comes Hayne. Floats the ball. Loco will score. Don't tell me we're seeing a repeat of last year's game. They scored 30 in 14.
Well, shoddy defence up the middle. Mitchell, all good. Able to spin out of a tackle. Good support play from Matt Keating. And an outstanding ball delivered from Jared Hayne. Off Paulo. A little gap outside. The defenders might have fallen off each other. And then Matt Keating offloads, and this is a great ball into the path of Loco.
Yeah, we're just saying that the Tigers had sort of clocked off for the night. They're feeling pretty good about themselves, the clock on the scoreboard. They look up, two quick tries. If Sando can slot this and make the margin 12, it's game back on.
Well, he slotted it. There's another two.
Well, look
at Andrew John.
Been waiting for this all night. Some strong running off Joseph Paulo. He goes to the line and tracks two defenders. And Allgood charges on a strong line on the outside and gets a one-on-one tackle. And it's the strength of the man to get him through. This is great support. But have a look at this class from Jared Hayne. Look at this for a ball. Absolute class. Hang on. 9 minutes to go. Two tries.
The similarities of round...
10, I think it was, the corresponding game of this last year. It was 31 blocked at the 66th minute, and the Tigers, via a penalty, a field goal by Benji at halftime, fell in by a point, with Parramatta scoring 30 points in the last 14. Here's Roberts giving it to Loco. Loco away from the sideline.
Well, you've only got to go back to last week. The Tigers were very poor in that last 10 minutes. It's like the man who got over and would have got over again if it hadn't been an obstruction call, and it was a questionable one.
Sando working on that left edge. It's gone to ground. And it's come down there. Morgan knocking on. Blair's with the ball.
Just wondering now if the Tigers work themselves towards maybe field goal range to get to that. Well, this will help. This will help.
Dragging down.
I'd say they'll go straight towards the post now and try and make it 31-18 and extend the lead to 13. That's a bad penalty. They've done that a couple of times tonight, Parramatta. They've made a mistake and then compounded it by giving a penalty away straight away out of frustration. Hurt big time on the Marshall tap and run. Not the only time tonight it's happened. And they really should just be thinking field goal here, the Tigers.
Magpies Heritage Celebration Dinner, Rick Wade asked me to mention it, at West Ashfield Leeds on Friday, April 12. Guest of honour, Arthur Summons and Norm Proven, commemorating 50 years since the 63 Grand Final and the birth of the Gladiators legend. Tickets through proticket.com.au. Proticket.com.au or from West Ashfield, commemorating 50 years since the 63 Grand Final when they still believe they were dudded. They still believe they got dudded. So here they are, thinking about 1 point.
Well, Miller's in the best position. He's gone right behind, but Benji's gone over to the left.
Here he is. Here he is. There it goes. There's the shot. Turns his back on it. Referee puts the arm in the air. And Jacob Miller kicks the point. And that takes them out to a 13-point buffer.
Very professionally done. And no doubt they have practiced that at training. Coming in to get 1 point. I always say, if your team can get 1 point when it needs it, it'll get you 2 points a lot. And that'll get them their 2 points tonight because it'll extend the lead to 13. And the fact that they had Marshall way out wide to the left was nice decoy for him.
Sando, skipping, running, speeding. And we'll play the ball 35 out.
Yeah, perfect short kickoff there. Batted back. And
now it's a penalty. Now it's a penalty.
Right there. Ready?
Tim Mann. And Jacob Miller, I take note, played juniors up at Mullumbimby. To all you people up on the Northern Rivers, yes, you're watching with interest his games with West Tigers. Sando, Paulo, and Roberts can't handle that. It went behind him. It was a very awkward ball to give him. There's been a knock on anyway, and knocked on by West Tigers. So it went back off Roberts. It can't be him, I don't think.
Yeah, they're saying that Fulton has knocked this on. Parramatta trying to get a scrum form to stop the clock.
Yes. All backwards off Parramatta, and Liam knocks it on the ground. He knows he does. He touches it. Here we go. Let's get in the scrum now, boys. Come on.
He's making a tackle.
Come on. Not going to argue and debate it. Hey, Liam, get in.
Yeah, he's right, the referee. Roberts knocked it back and Fulton knocked it on, trying to regather it.
It's time out. No, not yet.
5 minutes to go. And Parramatta with Loco, and Loco was hit by Reddy. Hit like a locomotive. Loco on Loco.
Yeah, but he nearly produced a try. Had his winger been in a little better position and moving quickly, this was an opportunity. Because he draws fence and flicks that. Look at that, he's got the finish. He's taken the two and the line's open. But the man was actually in front of him.
Righto, Tigers, let's go. Bring it up.
Inexperience.
Time in possession. Righto, and then I guess what you do with it when you're in possession, it's vital. it adds up to victory or loss. And I'm looking at the pendulum, how it swung in the second half. Parramatta's time in possession in the second half far exceeding that of West Tigers, which was the total reverse in the first half.
Tackle one! Four!
Tom Waterhouse will take a look at a couple of the big games over the weekend still to come. And we'll also talk to Tom about three Group 1 races at the Hill tomorrow. His mother's got a very strong hand in one of them, the Canterbury Stakes. 31-18 the scoreboard here. And that's crunched by Paulo and Manor. Farrow for Woods. Just under 4 minutes of this game at Leichhardt to go. Don't forget our telecast game on Sunday is Penrith up against South Sydney. And they will be a wonderful yardstick for Penrith to measure just where they might be in this competition, because there's a lot of people starting to believe that the Rabbits are going to be there on ground for day this early in the season. Got a wonderful roster.
Got to get out there.
It's the Panthers' turn to measure themselves against South Sydney on Sunday. 4 o'clock. 4 o'clock for telecast. Payne is cramped. Finding the line with the kick and then cramping. That's Mitchell Allgood. Hasn't been all good tonight, though, has it? Sando just popping a pass up then to Ben Smith. And he plays it, and Keating thinks there's a hole there, and he tries to get through it. Oh, Smith a dummy half, Big Ben. That's not your job. Sando with Roberts, and Roberts with Tanganoa. Tanganoa got the ball away. It'll bounce down. Oh, it's gone straight through the tunnel. Middle stump is gone. The stumps and bales everywhere as it went through Tautai's legs. There's another wicket.
All straight between bat and pad, which is a little bit like some other batsmen I've seen recently struggling overseas. But that got his middle stump. Cleaned him up.
Tanganoa's there trying to get up, and Liam, ride him cowboy. It's an interesting one there from Fulton. The kids, are part of a fairly embarrassing loss, and he decides to just hitch a ride on him.
Sorry, boys.
But that's Fulton.
He's a real practical jagger at the best of times.
Oh, he is.
You've got to be very careful with your message bank and your mobile phone, and he's got more tricks.
You don't want to take him on. Him and that other bloke who used to play at Balmain, Ronnie Ryan. You don't take either of them on.
Yeah, him and that Bryce Gibbs. You can't trust either of them. Bryce Gibbs, Liam Fulton.
Just keep naming them.
Yeah.
Well, they're the best.
Ready. Ready's okay.
They spend their whole life thinking of ways to get to them. Yeah.
They'll get at 3 o'clock in the morning. The kick for the last of previous night.
Tackle four, Ryan.
Well, he's back for the final curtain. See you, Manu Fani, or Farnai. It's gonna happen. There's gonna be a commentator strangling himself on some of these names one day. Strangulation of the larynx, or is it the larynx?
Larynx,
is it? Yeah. How did he die? Oh, he got strangled. He got a strangled larynx. What caused it? Well, just trying to pronounce the Polynesian names. Vonomataratu and Siu Manu Fani. They took him down eventually.
You'll get over it, Rabbits.
Not if I strangle myself on the larynx. The larynx. Manner.
It's a bit different to Billy Smith and Bobby Jones, isn't it?
Whatever happened to them? Here's Paulo. 22 seconds to go, Richie.
It's all over.
some brilliant stuff from the Tigers tonight. Some really brilliant stuff. Some other stuff a little bit lackadaisical. Parramatta no ball in the first half. Showed a little flash early in the second half, and then ill discipline drove them mad in the end.
Yes. Black and gold, yes. He says 31-18 in favour of the Tigers in their Skyfall jumpers, which are up for auction, autographed by all the players on the West Tigers website. Proceeds to charity. Plenty more to come on Nine's Friday Night Football. VB, hard-earned man of the match. Nine Orbit. We catch up with the stars of the game. And we see what's coming up this weekend on the one and only Wide World of Sports. The VB, hard-earned man of the match. After the